Life is one day at a time.com comes on every week with Minister Chestnut.
Chapter by chapter and verse by verse.
Every week, because Jesus is our rock.
Welcome to Life is One Day at a Time.com. I'm Minister Chestnut, and thank you for joining me again on another day of life and another day of love to live in His riches and glory. Praise God as we continue in the martyrdom of the apostles. Today, we're going to look into the apostle Thomas. Thomas, one of the 12 disciples of Jesus Christ, is shrouded in mystery and adventure. Amidst his travels to establish Christian communities, it is believed that Thomas embarked on a missionary journey to India during the first century AD. Thomas' missionary endeavors took place in an era when trade routes connected various regions across Asia. The Roman Empire had commercial ties with India through its Silk Road connections, facilitating communication and exchange between different cultures. Through these networks, Christianity found its way into Indian shores. Thomas's arrival in India marked a significant turning point for Christianity on the subcontinent. It is said that he landed in Muziris, now known as Kudungula, located along Kerala's Malabar coast, an entry point for merchants from foreign lands during ancient times. Here he encountered Jewish settlers who embraced his teachings and became initial converts. Churches were established by Thomas primarily along South India's coast regions, including present-day Kerala and Tamil Nadu states. His efforts proved crucial for expanding Christian faith beyond its Judeo-Roman roots into new cultural territories. According to tradition, it is one of these missionary journeys that Thomas met his untimely demise by being stabbed with a spear or lance near Chennai, then known as Mylapore, around 72 AD. While details are scarce due to limited historical evidence, local legends have preserved this account throughout generations. Despite facing adversity, he sought to spread Christianity throughout unfamiliar lands. Thomas left behind an indelible mark on Indian society. The churches he established continue to thrive today as vibrant centers of Christian worship. St. Thomas Christians, also known as Syrian Christians or Nazarai, proudly trace their heritage back to this apolitic lineage. Furthermore, the presence of Thomas in India underpins the country's rich religious diversity and heritage. Hinduism, Islam, Sikhism, Buddhism, Jainism have flourished alongside Christianity throughout Indian history. Amalgamation of faith have given rise to a pluralistic society where various religion traditions coexist harmoniously. The story of Thomas the Apostle missionary journey to India captivates our imagination with tales of adventure and sacrifice. While historic evidence regarding his exploits may be limited, the legacy he left behind is undeniable. Through his efforts in establishing churches and spreading the gospel on the Indian subcontinent, Thomas played a significant role in shaping Christianity's presence in an enduring, diverse nation. I mean, you have to look at the time period that he lived and the different religions that were going on all over the world. Hey, he faced a tremendous persecution, but hey, he did not deny his faith. Let's talk about the martyrdom of Jude. The martyrdom of Jude serves as a poignant example of unwavering dedication to one's faith in Christ. Despite facing persecution and the threat of death, Jude steadfastly refused to renounce his belief, ultimately meeting his fate at the hands of executioners armed with arrows. Jude, also known as Thaddeus or Lebanus, was one of Jesus' 12 disciples accompanying him during his missionary on earth. Following Jesus' resurrection and ascension into heaven, Jude embarked on a mission to spread the teaching of Christ far and wide. Tradition holds that he traveled extensively throughout Mesopotamia, Libya, Armenia, Persia, and Syria, while fearlessly proclaiming the gospel's message. As Christianity faced increasing opposition from both religious authorities and political powers during these times, believers often found themselves subject to severe persecution. It was this hostile environment that Jude found himself confronted by these who demanded he deny his faith or face dire consequences. When presented with an ultimatum to renounce Jesus Christ or face execution by arrows, a punishment notorious for his agonizing nature, Jude chose martyrdom. Rather than betraying his Lord, his resolute response showcased an unyielding conviction in Christ's teaching. I mean, it was serious. Can you imagine being faced with a group of non-believers with arrows getting ready to shoot you if you don't deny your faith? Hey, Jude wasn't going for it. In the manner in which Jude embraced martyrdom resonated deeply within early Christianity communities, grappling with their own struggles against persecution, his steadfastness became a source of inspiration for countless of believers who sought solace amidst trying circumstances. While historical records regarding the exact circumstances of Jude's martyrdom are scarce, early Christian writings and traditions suggest that he died a martyr's death. Pierced by arrows, the church venerates him as a saint and commemorates his feast day on October 28th. Jude's martyrdom continues to serve as a reminder of the sacrifices made by early disciples who fearlessly carried the message of Christ to distant lands. His unwavering faith in the face of persecution has inspired countless generations to remain steadfast in their own spiritual journeys than to stand firm on their belief. The martyrdom of Jews stands as an enduring testament to unyielding faith in Christ. His refusal to deny his belief, even when faced with imminent death, portrays an extraordinary commitment that has resonated throughout history. As we reflect upon his act of devotion, we are reminded not only of Jude's sacrifice, but also as a challenge to examine our own dedication and resolve in living with our faith with unwavering conviction. I mean, sometimes, like, even today in Israel, other parts of the world, people are losing their life standing up for their faith. Hey, it's a remarkable tale, but without faith, it's impossible to please God. So what do? Hey, you stand on your belief and you move on.
The Apostle Matthias.
This is the apostle that replaced Judas Iscariot. Following Judas Iscariot's betrayal and tragic end, an urgent need rose to fill the vacant apostolic position. The remaining 11 disciples believed that it was crucial to remain their unity and demonstrate their allegiance to Christ by replacing their fallen comrade, as described in Acts chapter 1, verses 15 to 26. Peter led this process by proposing that they choose someone who had witnessed Jesus' ministry from his baptism until his ascension. Multiple candidates met this criteria. However, after prayerfully seeking divine guidance, Matthias emerged as a chosen one through casting lots, a common method used during that time for decision making. This act symbolizes trust in God's sovereignty over human choices and solidified Matthias as an official apostle among his peers. Matthias quickly found himself navigating a challenging landscape as Christianity faced increasing opposition from both religious authorities and the Roman rule. As Christians spread throughout Jerusalem, alongside Judaic deep-rooted traditions, hostility toward followers of the way intensified. Although concrete historical evidence regarding Matthias' specific actions are scarce, early Christian sources such as the Clement of Alexandria suggest that he played an active role in spreading Christ's message beyond Jerusalem into foreign territories. These endeavors undoubtedly guarded him his notoriety among those who opposed his teachings of Jesus. According to various ancient Christian traditions, Matthias met a tragic and thorough stoning and beheading. While the precise details of his martyrdom remain largely speculative, these accounts emphasize his unwavering dedication to the Christian cause. Matthias' execution serves as a testament to the inherent risk faced by early Christians, missionaries, and their willingness to sacrifice their lives for their faith. Despite facing brutal persecution, Matthias remained steadfast in his commitment and ultimately paid the ultimate price for following Christ's teaching. The story of Matthias replacing Judas Iscariot offers an intriguing glimpse into the early days of Christianity, highlighting its triumphs and challenges. By examining this historical account, we see how Matthias' faithfulness played a vital role in solidifying Jesus' ministry throughout apostolic succession. Matthias was chosen as one who could carry on Christ's mission alongside his fellow apostles. His subsequent stoning and beheading underscored the sacrifices made by those who embraced Christianity during its early
stages of life.
I mean, this is after Jesus ascended. He gave the disciples power to spread the gospel, and they did it until they died. They did it facing death. They did it in spite of death, knowing that, hey, the next one they see was going to be Jesus. Hey, so to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. So it didn't bother them a bit to stand up for the cause, because Jesus is Lord. And I'm out of time. Hey, we'll pick this up next week as we continue another episode of Life is One Day at a Time.com.
Time.com comes on every week with Minister Chestnut.
Chapter by chapter and verse by verse.
Be there every week because Jesus is our rock.